Hello, welcome back to part 2. So, I'm a little bit... Okay.
Dr. Gray had been putting Jeremy through some thorough medical investigation. He was trying to break through Jeremy's stories and get to some...
So I need to do this again. Okay, now I remember. So I will do this again and I will... I do this again and then I come back. Alright, we're back.
Why does this keep happening? What am I supposed to do? Again.
And we're back here. Perfect time to have a look around this place. What is that?
It's another fossil. Let's try 6-4.
Hmm.
So someone hung himself though. Is there something else I should be looking for? Probably not.
No, is this... This is where Jeremy's hiding, right?
Hello? Is anyone there?
Jeremy?
I need help!
Wait! Can you hear me?
I'm stuck in the mud and the fire is taking me.
Jeremy, where are you?
The motor is dead. I can't do anything more.
Hang on, Jeremy. I'll figure something out. I'll get the boat running.
I'm just gonna check around to see if there's anything else. Thank you. One shotgun shell and like 3-4 bullets.
The boat's wedged itself right into the bayou. If I get the motor started, I could try reversing back into the river.
Do I go up or down the sewers? I'm gonna go down the sewer.
Jeremy, where are you?
So now there's two options. I could jump down there. Or I could take the boat. Don't really know what to do. I'm gonna jump down. So I feel like I did the right thing. So now I'm gonna go up and take the boat.
The winch is powered by electricity. I need to find a way to turn it on before I can use it.
So I need to go on the other side. I see.
Looks pretty weak. This definitely needs fuel.
So I have to find fuel. pretty convenient. It's just like a ladder.
Years ago, Frederick needed me to die.
You're not making any sense, Jeremy. Come back. Find your focus.
Hey!
I cheated everyone. I didn't play my part.
Hey!
I escaped my doom.
My destiny.
Again, find your focus.
Hey, I'm right here. What the hell is going on?
Now everything is wrong. Nothing is in place.
I'm right here!
Calm down, Mr. Conby. What do you want?
Were you not talking to Jeremy right now?
I haven't seen Jeremy all day. Are you all right, Detective?
No. Actually, I don't think so. Well, maybe. I'm gonna go look for Jeremy.
Good. Let me know if you find him.
That was Jeremy's self-deceit? A steamboat stuck in the mud? I'm not going to pretend I understand any of that. What a bunch of psychoanalytic nonsense.
Maybe he's actually going insane.
Jeremy was calling out for help, but Conby couldn't figure out where...
map is like saying that there's still a puzzle over here. It has to be. Has to be the safe. I unlocked it. There it is. Where's Grace room? There's the empty room. So I'm gonna go up and see if I can find Grace room. This room should be here. This is Grace rooms.
Surprisingly neat. Maybe I've been selling that old barfly short.
Sometimes.
Looks like McCarthy has something hidden inside.
This is my room. I belong here. I know the combination. I carry it with me.
Which one is it?
I know that number. Where's that from?
I did this. I wrote that.
196. Okay, so 196. It could be 692.
Detective, I have made many discoveries in my case.
How long have I been here?
Probably a while.
Looks like McCarthy has something hidden inside.
Oh, yeah,
why would McCarthy lock this up? Was he trying to keep Grace from completing this chain? If so, couldn't she have just made it?
What the hell happened in here?
Oh shit. There's the door. Yeah, it's getting a bit weird.
Thank you.
to the hood or something. I guess I do have to line up with the mold. This doesn't really line up. I feel like it has to be like this. And just need to be like this. No? I feel like everyone lines up pretty well, except for this one, so I don't know, maybe like this though, yeah. I feel like it has to be like this now. Got it.
Huh? What?
Where's that?
This looks familiar.
How am I back at that's me, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
since I drowned myself in drink. Depression. It all felt so peaceful, slipping away into oblivion. A welcoming dark voice wrapped around my mind like a heavy blanket. It turned off suddenly as I woke up from the sound of my office door closing shut. A messenger had left a telegram from Mrs. Saunders. She had a lead on where to find her husband and her kidnapped daughter. God, I used to drink so much back then. When was this exactly? What case was I working? I think I need to figure out where I'm going first. I remember this case. Some kid got taken by her father, headed out of state, but he had made a mistake by selling a painting that his wife actually cared about to a collector named Thornhill to fund his venture. That's how I tracked him down. At least I think so.
Yeah, this is pretty interesting.
Principles keeping him from handing out information about his deals. So he needed some convincing.
Well, every case can't be squeaky clean.
Mr. Saunders had sold a valuable painting to Thornhill, hoping the money would carry him to wherever he was going. The painting, now leaning on an easel in Thornhill's bedroom, had a certain mesmerizing gloom that seemed to call out to me, telling me I was needed for something important. I felt myself falling into the painting, only being brought back by Thornhill, thrusting an address to a Hotel St. George into my hand, and asking me to get the hell out.
Say it didn't happen.
Did I go check though? Pick up the shotgun.
Mm.
Where do I go from there? Up here.
On my way to the hotel, the Morton gang caught up with me. I owed them money, a lot of it. I can't remember what for, probably some dumb gambling debt growing in size for each payment missed. I punched one of them out, and I sent the others packing. Just... too much bullets. He's not gonna catch me anymore. I found him. In the hotel ledger, I recognized the handwriting of the signature, Ted Stryker. It was him. I could feel it. It was the kidnapper I was hunting. I put on my knuckles and hurried up to his room.
Something about that name, Ted Stryker, rings a bell. Feels vaguely familiar. This room. But I didn't catch up with them here. I must have followed them. But where? This must be where the bridge is operated.
Oh, thought you'd use some shotguns. Some shotgun ammo then.
Nothing's happening. It's like something's holding it back.
Yeah, kind of looks that way. To the boat now. I can move.
I can't go that way.
Then I remember where the boat is. It kind of reminds me of the Evil Dead, the single, like the single player. Like the challenge or whatever. The boat were her. Maybe not. Yeah, the thing is I can't remember anymore. Yeah, it's all right. There we go.
Are you okay?
Don't leave me alone.
What the hell have you been doing?
What's going on here? Look at this mess!
I'm sorry, Mrs. Thompson.
Don't make me kick you out of this house! Now get out!
Hey, Detective. Mr. Carnby. I'm really worried about you.
I'm okay. I just need to catch my breath for a moment.
This place? It's... There are some very disturbed figures around here. And I don't think it's just the patients. I've been reading some things about how Dorsetto has a deranging effect on people. I think it might explain things.
What?
Just take it easy, okay? I'm gonna go find a way into Dr. Gray's apartment. I wanna know what he's hiding.
Emily, don't worry. I think I'm close. I'm gonna set everything right.
Just be careful.
I think that's actually the picture frame that I was looking for.
I'm not going in there. She's clearly had enough of me.
Conby had run their car off the bridge. He pulled.
Yes, that is his apartment.
We must have faith.
It's blocked.
So everything's locked down now.
It's blocked.
Everything is fucked.
I don't want to run into the orderlies right now. Not sure I can trust them.
Detective, am I glad to see you. Lock the door, will you? I don't think Dr. Gray would appreciate us snooping around.
What's going on here? This feels so strange.
Pretty cool, actually.
There's a book missing.
What did you do?
I was just rearranging the books.
Well, come on, let's check it out.
Just wait a moment, though. There might be something else. Though. Maybe not.
Beginning to understand. Dr. Gray is dealing with some kind of mass delusion.
No, turn around.
Huh.
Has that been there this whole time?
Good to finally meet you, Mr.
That mark on the floor looks like talisman positions, but from which direction should I look at it?
The snake dagger.
What were you saying about mass delusion?
Dorsetto seems to have a deranging effect on people living close by. It has a history of creating cults devoted to some nature goddess. Even the name Dorsetto refers to the cult existing here before the Civil War. Dorsetto was the name of an ancient fertility goddess worshipped in Syria. Dr. Gray and his friends, however, seem to prefer the black goat of the woods with a thousand young, or Shub-Niggurath. And that name can only have come from my uncle's twisted mind.
Where's the phone?
Hello?
Detective Carnby?
Who is this? Jeremy?
Jeremy is with the Dark Man. You can't save him.
Well, I've done everything he wanted so far, and there's just one more thing on the list. I expect him to keep his promise and return Jeremy unharmed.
Get out, Detective. While you still can.
To be some clues over here. So there's a portal. Let's see.
You okay? You look a little frazzled.
Just stupid telephone.
I know. I tried calling the police earlier. The telephone is completely dead.
It's not... Yeah, no, the telephone isn't working. Miss Hartwood, I think you're gonna want to see this.
Is there something in the closet?
Yeah, there is. You don't see the very obvious gate leading to whatever Jeremy's madness is serving up next?
I don't understand. Are you making some kind of fashion metaphor? I'm sorry, I don't have time for this. Can you just tell me what you're doing?
You don't see this. It's fine. It's fine. Catch you later.
Are you going inside the closet?
Yeah. You got a problem with that?
No. Do what you think is right, Detective.
Sorry, I didn't mean to. Goodbye, Miss Hartwood.
She doesn't like notice that something's off when I disappear. Winter time.
We found the ancient Stellarium perched on a cliff.
Hey, you! What are you doing here? What is this place?
Turn back, detective. You're not wanted here.
Whoa, take it easy. I'm not your enemy.
Oh, you're wrong, detective. You're wrong.
Ah!
Maybe it did damage a lot. I got a chance to my normal pistol.
Stars align, Jeremy, or maybe that is what you need to temper that mania of yours.
We did everything! Aren't you happy? Stupid charlatan! What more do you want from me? You want me to lose my mind?
Oh, my love! Doctor! Baptiste! Quick!
What the fuck?
Jesus. What were you thinking, compadre?
Be knocked out for the rest of the night. Come on out and join us, will you? I'll save you some gumbo.
Good to have you back. You gave us all a good scare.
What happened?
You had a psychological breakdown. Sorry for manhandling you, but you're being violent.
You stabbed Jeremy and then punched Dr. Gray.
Are they okay?
Jeremy's a little strange, but everything's back to normal.
Really?
All thanks to you, Combat. You want to try standing up?
Well, if it isn't the hero of the day. How are you feeling, Detective?
Never better. How about you two? Hey, Jeremy, I didn't do too much damage, did I?
Things are fine. Very quiet.
What's up with him? Painkillers?
No. You see, despite you having the finesse of a one-eyed butcher, you managed to lobotomize dear Jeremy.
I did what?
It's actually quite impressive. It's not like I hadn't considered it myself. I just wish Jeremy could have been helped without reducing his personality to that of an oyster.
But he's gonna live.
Of course. As long as someone keeps feeding him, he'll outlive the best of us.
Does Emily know about Jeremy's condition?
Yes. She seems to be handling it quite well under the circumstances.
Does she still want to take Jeremy away from Dorsetto?
I will have to insist that you do. This is not that kind of institution.
Jeremy! Hang on for a little longer, okay? We'll be going back to New Orleans soon.
Oh, good. I do so miss the city lights.
Case closed. Detective...
Good to see you back on your feet, Detective. Have some gumbo.
Thanks. I'll save it for later.
Guess the game is over now. The ending was a bit weird.
What are you looking for?
Just keeping an eye out for the storm. Radio says it could be a wild one.
Everyone knows what to do. Y'all know the new words.
Mrs. Thompson, we talked about this. I'm not sure everyone is comfortable.
Doctor, I insist. This is important. We've waited for so long, Doctor.
Let's just go with the old song. Not every change is an improvement.
Boss, good or bad, you need to move forward.
All in, Doc. Let's bet it all. But we don't know what we're dealing with.
It'll be okay, Doctor. Better even.
Ever there praises in abundance to the black goat of the woods. Hear us, brother. Take pity on us. Take pity on us.
Ever there praises in abundance to the black goat of the woods.
Hear us, brother, and take pity on us. Take pity on us.
Ever there praises in abundance to the
black goat of the woods. Hear us, brother, and take pity on us.
Judge! Are you crazy?
This is what needs to happen, Coffin.
Grace! Stop! Jeremy, come with me. Get over here.
Oh,
Jeremy, come with me. Jeremy, come here.
No, there has to be an afterblast.
Window. I can't let that monster leave Dersetto. I have to stop it.
I mean, I guess the god was coming through, to be honest. Where do I go?
Huh?
was my first death. This is actually a bit challenging.
Fuck.
Started all over. That's where there's everything after. I don't know what this does do any damage, something like that. Right. Oh.
Detective! Oh,
what the hell was that?
I try to tell you. There was so much evidence. Their devotion to the Black Goat was like nothing I've ever seen before. I felt so dumb believing any of it, but I'm glad I did.
Are you okay?
Everything is out of order. This isn't the way the story goes. I shouldn't be alive.
Yeah. Well, you're welcome, buddy.
How are you doing, sweetie?
I kinda like it. You ruined everything, but I'm not mad.
All right, you ready to head back to New Orleans?
Come on, Jeremy. We're leaving.
Can I come?
I thought you said you didn't need saving.
Don't leave her. She's important.
Of course we're taking her with us.
Yay, I'm important.
It looks like this is the end. I like the game. Vita's story was pretty good. Got a bit derailed in the end. But I feel like in some places you can notice that it wasn't really made by like a big budget or a studio, but I feel like it was I saw it like six and a half. Maybe even 7. I feel like for the price that I paid like $30 for it, I feel like for the price it's pretty okay. For a full price game, I don't really know. And the ending was a bit weird. Every like since I stabbed Jeremy and that stuff went a little bit over my head. I still liked it. I enjoyed it. Gameplay and thanks for watching, please leave a like and subscribe and see you next time.